represented here by Suraj Gola from Buddha School, Gurugram, are replicas of two terracotta figurines depicting a horse and a fierce-looking being, both of which form an important part of the Ayanar worship tradition. The artifacts are currently a part of the collections at the Sanskriti Museum of Indian Terracotta, Delhi. The tradition of Ayanar worship is predominantly practiced in southern India, where he is venerated as a village guardian deity. The roots of this practice can be traced to as early as the 3rd century CE. The next artifact is an 18th century Bhairava sculpture presented by Kashvi Jain from G.D. Goenka Public School, Jammu. The artifact is currently a part of the collection at the Dogra Art Museum, Jammu. The earliest mention to Bhairava can be traced back to the Puranic period. While different Puranas give a different narrative for the origin of Bhairava, all of them highlight his association with Shiva. Iconographical literature states that Bhairava is one of the Samhara Murtis of Shiva and may be shown in different forms. The next artifact is a sculpture of the four-armed Chanda, a Buddhist deity, presented by Ayush Goel from DAV Public School, Ballabgarh. This sculpture dates approximately to the 11th century CE and is currently a part of the collection at the National Museum, Delhi. Chanda, as a deity, seems to have risen to popularity after she was adopted as the patron goddess by the Pala dynasty of Bengal. As per Buddhist sources, Chanda is considered as an embodiment of the Chanda Dharani. This artifact, chosen and presented by Anushka Patel from Navy Children's School, Mumbai, is a coping stone from a stupa in Amravati, Guntur district, Andhra Pradesh. The artifact can be traced to the 2nd century CE and is currently a part of the collection at the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Vastu Sangrahalaya, Mumbai. The Dona Sutta of the Anguttara Nikaya from the Sutta Pitaka, one of the canonical Buddhist texts, narrates an incident where the Buddha uses the analogy of the lotus to explain his enlightenment. Here, he states that, like the lotus which is born in muddied and stagnant waters, rises above the water untarnished by it, he too, being born in the world of suffering and impermanence, lived unsmeared by it. This analogy from the Buddhist canonical literature can be seen translated to the use of the lotus as a recurring motif in Buddhist art, not only to symbolize Buddha himself, but also as a representation of his enlightenment. The artifact presented by Ishan Bhalerao is a mutoscope that can be dated to the year 1900. The artifact is currently a part of the collection at the National Museum of Indian Cinema, Mumbai. The mutoscope is a manually operated early motion picture device invented by Hermann Gassler in the year 1959. The working of the mutoscope somewhat resembles the concept of a flipbook, where a series of cards in the device would flip to present moving reels. The cards were usually electrically lighted, but the reel was operated by a geared down hand crank. Each machine was designed to display a single reel and was dedicated to the presentation of a single short subject. Chosen and presented by Team MBS from the Navy Children's School, Mumbai, this artifact is a ceiling slab depicting Vishnu in his Sheshashayi form. The artifact can be dated to the 7th century CE and is currently a part of the collection at the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Vastu Sangrahalaya. Ancient Indian architectural texts mention Vishnu to be the only deity that is iconographically permitted to be depicted in a reclining posture. Such depictions of Vishnu are called Shayanamurtis. The next artifact, presented by Team NCSRAA from the Navy Children's School, Mumbai, is a fragment of a Prabhavali. This artifact can be dated approximately to the 13th-14th century CE. The artifact, which was once a part of a Jain temple at Supara, is currently located in the Center for Extramural Studies at the University of Mumbai, Kalina campus. Prabhavali, also known as Prabhavalaya, refers to the ornate arch that is usually depicted around the figure of any deity. Prabhavalis usually bear icons and figures that depict legends related to the deity or those that are in veneration of the central deity. The artifact chosen and presented by Team Teen Seekers from Mayur School, Noida, is a statue of Kubera, the god of wealth in the Hindu pantheon. This artifact is presently a part of the collection at the National Museum, Delhi, and can be dated back to the 2nd century CE. Kubera first finds mention in the Vedic literature. Here, he is mentioned as the chief of the spirits of darkness or as the lord of thieves and criminals. It is only in the Puranic and epic literature that Kubera is truly venerated as the god of wealth. This artifact, presented by Team Kalam Kamal from the Chennai Public School, is a bronze idol of Ardhanarishvara. Excavated in Thiruvengadu, the idol is currently a part of the collection of the Government Museum, Chennai. The artifact can be dated back to the 11th century CE, with its craftsmanship being attributed to the Chola dynasty. While the idea of a combined duality appears within the Indian subcontinent as early as the Vedic period, the present-day concept of Ardhanarishvara was developed only in the Puranic period. The iconography of Ardhanarishvara usually depicts the right half as Shiva and the left half as Parvati. This artifact of the Vrishanina Yogini or the Buffalo-headed Yogini is presented by Team The Antiquarians from Mayur School, Noida. This sculpture traces its origin approximately to the 10th century CE and belongs to a group of 20 Yogini sculptures that were a part of the Lokhari temple in Uttar Pradesh. The Yogini tradition is said to have stemmed from village cult goddesses before it was incorporated within the practice of Tantra. A very common aspect observed in the Yogini tradition is that of depicting the Yoginis with heads of various animals.